Can I walk around this?
Sure. Just once it's strapped in, it's easy.
Right.
Oh, I see. The food.
That's lessons learned. Gotta wear a hat.
Wait a minute. I can't do that. I can climb up that
Okay, I used to have this kind of music in my old museum, and it was playing in the museum all the time.
I think I'd have loved it when I was 16. I did. I used to go with my boyfriend. He had a plane.
Oh, you're not in the picture. Don't worry. Way up too high. You know, the amazing thing is I've never been in a biplane or an open cockpit at all.
I haven't either.
And I was surprised about how smooth it was.
Oh, really?
I expected it to be, you know, vibrate-y or something. It was very smooth.
Windy?
You know, we only encountered the lightest couple of bumps in one or two places where it just, like going over a rough spot in the road, but nothing...
Put it on your head.
Look at me in the shade.
Well, but you don't. Yeah. Even when you're here, you should.
I don't want to wear his hat.
Okay. You afraid you might grow some hair? Been up in everything. Not a fighter.
You will have?
Yep. You know, I have a couple friends who have private planes.
Okay.
Certainly been up in enough commercials.
Right.
Been up in a glider.
I took lessons in a glider.
Did you really?
That's a biplane.
Is it? Oh, yeah.
It's our plane.
Well, now that guy doesn't know what I'm standing
on my way. Don't get in my way! Don't get in my way! Don't get in my way! I got it all ready for the flyby. Yeah, take a picture of me sitting in the plane. I never thought of that. That'd be nice.
Do they only do this on Saturdays?
No, we do it every
day. That's the stuff you're going to keep. Here's the camera.
Okay.
Now, remember that this is the telephoto. So when you take a picture, take one wide angle and one telephoto up close of me in the cockpit, would you?
And every day,
as long as we're going to get one, let's get a good one. This is David's stuff here.
Okay.
The travel air will be the only thing during the week. Wampo flies another 10 days. It had to have some recovery.
Thank you for the ride.
Metal Airplane Company and manufactured by Ford Motor Company. It was delivered to Eastern Air Transport, whose colors it's in today, which eventually became Eastern Airlines. They used it for about 4 years as their one of their first scheduled airliners. And then it went to Havana, Cuba. It was operated by Habana Airlines for several years. Then it went to the Dominican Republic, who utilized it as our equivalent of Air Force One. In other words, it flew their president for several years. And then it kind of hopscotched around to several countries, Panama, several countries in Central America, and returned to the United States in 1951 to a gentleman in Arizona. I won't try to compete with him. So. Even though it's music. That gentleman utilized it in the Arizona area flying rides for several years. He eventually sold it to a company in Idaho that used it to fly smoke jumpers. The bottom of the door, which is now flat with the floor, was originally rounded like the top of the door. they modified it during that period of time when it was operated as a smoke jumper airplane to let them allow those guys to be able to get out of the airplane with all their equipment on a little easier. They utilized it until about 1963 when a gentleman in Topeka, Kansas bought it. The first year he owned it, he put a great big tank inside of the fuselage and used it to spray crops and stuff like that. Realized that that wasn't a good thing to do, so he put seats back in it and operated it for several years, flying around air shows and stuff like that in the Midwest. The EAA bought it in 1973 with the intent to fly rides in it at air shows and aviation events. In 1974, the airplane was at Burlington, Wisconsin, and a large windstorm came up and turned the airplane upside down, virtually destroying the airplane. And Paul Pope Resner decided that he would buy the airplane primarily to salvage the engines and what metal he could out of it. But he had numerous friends who decided that since it is a very significant aviation artifact, talked him into rebuilding the airplane. So over a period of 14 years, the staff here, maintenance staff and volunteers, rebuilt the airplane, basically remanufactured the aircraft, except for the left outboard main wing. They even found the roller machines that Ford Motor Company had used to corrugate the metal with, and rebuilt that machine to enable them to recover the airplane. And then they put it back into service in 1986, I think it was, here at Pioneer Airport, flying rides on the weekends. And then they eventually expanded it to do numerous air shows and aviation events, flying passengers in the upper Midwest primarily. And we still do that from time to time. And last month, another pilot and myself took it to Minneapolis. We were over there for the weekend at an aviation event over there. It is the only remaining Ford that flies on a regular basis. There's another one in Michigan that flies, but they've decided not to fly it any further because of the cost of insurance. So, of the 199 Fords that were built, you're going to have the opportunity to experience what airline flying was like back in the 1920s and 30s. Other than that, I think we're ready to go fly.
y'all enjoyed your flight?
Well, it was wonderful. Yeah. All right.
Floating down behind the trees.
Sneaking up on you.
Very hard. Yeah.